FixedUpdate is one of the most commonly used functions in Unity. It's called once per frame on every script that uses it. Almost anything that needs to be changed or adjusted regularly happens here. The movement of non-physics objects, simple timers, and the detection of input are just a few things that are usually done in Update. Note that Update is not called on a regular timeline. If one frame takes longer to process than the next, then the time between update calls will be different. FixedUpdate is a similar function to update, but it has a few important differences. FixedUpdate is called on a regular timeline and will have the same time between calls. Immediately after FixedUpdate is called, any necessary physics calculations are made. As such, anything that affects a rigid body, meaning a physics object, should be executed in FixedUpdate rather than update. When scripting physics in the FixedUpdate loop, it's good practice to use forces for movement. Let's take a look at the difference between FixedUpdate and update calls. In this example, we're logging to the console with each FixedUpdate and update by adding the value of time.deltaTime. When I press play and pause, you can see that the time between fixed updates is always 0.02, whereas the time between updates varies. This can be shown even more clearly by collapsing the console. If I play now and pause, you can see that all of my fixed updates are collapsed into one. Even though there's a large number of them, we can see that they are all 0.02. Whereas the update times vary. Update and many other special functions in Unity can be created quickly and easily in Visual Studio by using the Mono Behavior Scripting Wizard. In Visual Studio, position the cursor where you want the new function to be inserted, then press Ctrl-Shift-M to launch the wizard. In the Create Script Methods window, mark the checkbox next to the name of each method you want to add. Choose the OK button to exit the wizard and insert the methods into your code. Using the wizard in this way can help you to avoid errors in your code and also help you to discover what functions are available as you're learning.